हेलो एवरीवन, आई प्रोफेसर तृप्ति घुमड़े वेलकम्स यू ऑल फॉर द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ एसटीएलडी दैट इज स्विचिंग थ्योरी एंड लॉजिक डिजाइन। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग एनी सब्जेक्ट इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आर द कोर्स आउटकम्स एसोसिएटेड विद दैट सब्जेक्ट। कोर्स आउटकम्स आर नथिंग बट द व्हाट एवर यू लर्न फ्रॉम दैट पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट। सो देयर आर सिक्स वेरियस कोर्स आउटकम्स फॉर द सब्जेक्ट एसटीएलडी। फर्स्ट वन इज Explain fundamental concept of VHDL modeling. VHDL stands for Very High Scale Integrated Circuit Hardware Description Language. So, VHDL is a hardware description language which describes the behavior of hardware, or we can say that which describes the behavior of digital logic circuits. So, basically, there are three styles of VHDL modeling. First one is data flow style of modeling, second structural style of modeling, and third one is behavioral style of modeling. VHDL language is also used for developing high end sophisticated microprocessors or microcontrollers. Then course outcome number 2, which is associated with the unit number 2 of STLD, discuss about the syntax and behavior of VHDL language. So in this you will be able to learn about all the syntaxes of the VHDL language and behavior of VHDL, that is how it behaves in different styles of modeling in VHDL. Then course outcome number 3, illustrate reduction of logical expression using Boolean algebra, K-map and tabulation method, and implement the functions using logic gates. So Boolean algebra talks about the Boolean functions, various functions that you want to implement. Let's say we want to implement adder, subtractor and so on. So when we talk about Boolean functions, there are various ways to represent these functions and then how to manipulate these functions. So when we're talking about realizing these functions into gate, one thing is very important, that is minimization. In minimization, we are basically concerned about how to reduce or minimize the number of logic gates that are required to realize a particular given function. Then course outcome number 4, that is design combinational logic circuits for a given application. Basically, logic circuits are divided into two types. First one is combinational logic circuit and second one is sequential logic circuits. So combinational logic circuits are those circuits whenever you apply an input, immediately you will get an output. Then course outcome number 5, that is CO5, implement combinational circuit for a given application. After learning about the concept of combinational circuit, you will be able to implement those combinational circuits for a given application. Then course outcome number 6, that is design and analysis of synchronous and asynchronous sequential circuits using flip-flop. Synchronous circuits are easy to understand, but asynchronous circuits are really difficult to handle and analyze. So in a normal sequential circuit, there is a concept of clock or periodic signal which synchronizes the activity of the system. So whenever there is a clock, only then the system will change its state from one state to another state. But in case of asynchronous circuit, there is no clock. So depending on the input, the way we change the input and the way input arrive, the system will automatically adapt itself and change its state. So after course outcome, we are having a program outcome. Program outcomes are nothing but the attribute for Bachelor of Engineering. So there are 12 various program outcomes, such as engineering knowledge, problem analysis, design or development of solutions, conduct investigations of complex problem, modern tool uses, the engineer and society, ethics, individual and teamwork, communication, and last one is the lifelong learning. So after the CO and PO, to achieve that course outcome, we must have a well-designed syllabus. So let's see the syllabus for STLD. It contains 6 units, The first unit will cover all the introductory part of VHDL concept. Now unit number 1, that is VHDL modeling concept and VHDL fundamentals. So in the first unit, you are going to learn about the fundamental concepts of VHDL, modeling concepts of VHDL. As I told you, there are three styles of modeling in VHDL, that is data flow, structural and behavioral. Then type classification, that means data type. As we know that every data has a type associated with it. Then expressions, operators and sequential statements, that is if statement, case, null, loop, assertion and report statements. Then unit number 2, that is array and VHDL. Operations of array, entity declaration, behavioral description and structural description. These are the types of VHDL style of modeling. Then unit number 3, that is minimization of switching function. Unit 3 is all about the minimization of switching function. So in this unit, we mainly focus on minimization or reduction of switching functions, because we know that smaller the function or expression, it is easier for us to design a circuit. So in this unit, we see different techniques for minimization of the switching function. K-map is one of the technique for minimization up to 4 variable. After that, we will see the limitations of K-map, implementation of logic functions and QAnd method. Then unit number 4, that is combinational logic design. As I told you, we can classify the logic circuits into two types, that is combinational logic circuit and sequential logic circuit. So combinational logic circuits are those, whenever you applied an input, immediately you will get an output. After that, unit number 5, that is serial adder, BCD adder, XS3 adder, subtractor, multipliers, encoder, decoders and multiplexer. So unit number 5 is all about the implementation of combinational circuits. Then last unit, that is sequential circuit designs. Second type of circuit is sequential circuit. Sequential circuits are those circuits in which even if you apply the input, the output not only depends on what you have applied but also on the previous history of the system. So these sequential circuits are sometimes called as or represented as finite state machine. There are again various ways to minimize this finite state machine. When we talk about the finite state machine, there is another one important concept, that is algorithmic state machine, which is called as ASM, which can be used to design bigger circuits. So this is an outline for the syllabus of STLD. After that, to learn this subject, there are various textbooks and reference books. So the textbook which is always recommended you to use is Anand Kumar, Switching Theory and Logic Design. And then these are the various reference books which you can be used to understand the concept of STLD.